If only it hadn't happened like this. The Argo hadn't opened its sails, flown to Colchis with flashing rocks. The tall pines were still standing in the glens of Mount Pelion. Mount Cuthon turned to oars for the Argonauts. Peleus the king hadn't sent our heroes to do his bidding and cross the sea to steal the Golden Fleece. It would all be different. Not as it is. They're singing in the village. Today may be a feast day for them.
I hate their feast days. I hate their joy.
That does not concern us. Back home, our feast days came earlier in June. The girls with flowers in their hair. The boys would paint their faces red with blood. And then in the early morning hours, after the first sacrifices, they would begin to fight. Oh, how handsome our Colchis boys look when they fight.
Be still.
Afterwards, they would spend the rest of the day taming wild animals. In the evening, they would set large fires outside your father's palace. Large yellow bonfires that smelled strongly of herbs. Have you forgotten the fragrance of our native plants, child?
Be still, good woman. Not another word.
Alas, I am old. The way is long. Why did we leave, Medea?
We left because I loved Jason. Because I betrayed my father for him. Because I killed my innocent brother for him. Be still, good woman. Be still. Do you think it is wise to repeat these things over and over again?
You had a palace with walls of gold, and now we squat here like two beggars before a fire that always dies out.
Go and fetch some wood. Listen, someone is coming on the road.
No, it is the wind. Do not wait for him any longer, my dove. You're eating your heart out. If it is indeed a feast day, they've invited him there, and your Jason is now dancing. Dancing with the daughters of Pelasgus. Here we sit. You and I.
Be quiet, old hag.
I won't say a word.
Smell.
Smell what?
Their happiness. How it stinks even to this very fire. Though they have confined us far enough away. They were afraid we'd steal their chickens during the night. But why do they sing and dance? Do I sing? Do I dance?
They are fortunate. They're in their own homes. Their day's work is done. Do you remember how white the palace looked at the end of the Cypress Road when we returned from our long rides? You would give your horse to the slave, and then you would throw yourself on the divans. I would call for the maids to bathe you, dress you. You were the mistress. You were the king's daughter. Nothing was too beautiful for you. Then they'd bring you dresses from the great chests. You would make your selection. calm and naked while they rubbed you with oil.
Be quiet, you fool. You are too stupid. Do you think I miss a palace, dresses, and slaves?
On the run. Always on the run, ever since!
And I could have kept on running away.
Chased, beaten, scorned, without a country, without a home?
Scorned, beaten, chased, without a country, without a home? But not alone.
You drag me along with you, as old as I am, and if I die, where would you leave me?
In a hole. On the side of the road, anywhere, old hag. And I, too, I accepted that.
He's
not alone.
He's leaving you, Medea.
No, he... Listen.
It is the wind. It is a feast day. He will not return tonight again.
But what is this feast day? What happiness is it that stinks even to hear of their sweat, their cheap wine, and their greasy food? People of Corinth, why do you shout so and dance? What makes you so gay this evening while I am so choked and oppressed? Nurse. Nurse, tonight I feel as though I were in labor. I suffer, and I am scared, as when you helped me pull a child from my womb. Help me, nurse. Something stirs in me as in the old days, and it is something that says no to their joy over there, something that says no to happiness. Nurse, if I cry out, you will put your hand over my mouth. And if I struggle, you will hold me tight, won't you?
Yes.
You won't let me suffer all alone, please.
No.
Hold me, nurse. Oh, hold me with all your strength. Hold me as you did when I was a little girl, as you held me on that night when I almost died in childbirth. I still have something to bring into this world tonight, and something bigger and more alive than myself, and I do not know if I will be strong enough.
Excuse me. What? Are you Medea?
Yes. Speak up. I know.
Then you know that Jason has sent me.
He won't come back. He's wounded? He's dead?
Calm yourself. He sends word that you're safe.
He won't return?
He will return. But you are to wait here for him.
He won't return? Where is he?
He's with Priam, the king at his palace.
Imprisoned?
No.
Yes! This feast day, it is for him? Speak! You can see that I know it is for him!
Yes, it is for him.
What has he done? Come!
quickly, child. You have run all this way. Your face is flushed, and you are anxious to return. They are dancing, are they not?
Yes.
And drinking?
People who are welcome drink from the 6 large barrels of wine outside the palace.
And they play games, and guns and fireworks light up the sky. Well, come, tell me, child, and you will have played your part. Return there and enjoy yourself. You do not know me. What difference can it make to you what you are going to tell me? Why? Does my face frighten you? Do you want me to smile? There you are. I am smiling. Besides, it must be good news since they are dancing. Tell me, quickly, child, since I know.
You're Jason. You will be marrying the king's daughter. The wedding is tomorrow morning.
Thank you, child. Now, go and dance with the girls of Corinth. Dance all night long, as much as you can. And when you are old, remember that you were the one who broke the news to Medea.
What shall I tell him?
Tell whom?
Jason.
Tell him that I thanked him.